Yo, it's Big Ant, man. We back. Another edition of Urban Politicians TV. Had to come tap in one time with the wheelchair goat, man.
What's the deal? What's the deal?
Yeah, died here in Detroit making the rounds, man. You one of the ones I came across recently. My boy BP put me on you. And so you instantly stood out because I was like, okay, you talking that talk that I'm normally used to hearing. Yeah. But you was harmonizing with it too. Oh, and the bars was hitting. I was like, okay, nah, dog popping this shit, man. I'm fucking with it, man. I gotta see what's up whenever I come out here. So shit, I made it, came out, dog. So, you know, introduce yourself to the people, tell them where you from and all that.
What's the deal, man? It's Wheelchair Goat, man. I'm from Detroit, Michigan, East Warren, dead zone.
Yeah, man. So you know, coming up over there, dog, what that situation there like, that East Warren?
Shit. My hood was smooth for real. Everybody, I mean, My hood ran together, for real, you feel me? Like, shit, we ain't really hang too much outside of our hood, so. Yeah. So my hood close to all the people that's over there and shit like that. Everybody really kind of stick together for real. That shit like its own community, for real.
Oh, shit, okay. Is it, that's like in a certain section, that's on the east side, so it's like.
Yeah, that's the east side of Detroit.
Yep. Okay, for shit. So I went through McNichols yesterday, street. McNichols. I rode all the way to like the end. I met one of my YouTube supporters at the Valero.
Okay.
Yeah, I ain't gonna drop. He's a little wild though, so I went on dipped out on him. But you know, I rock with him. He still be supporting me. Yeah, he had a lot of shit going on. I ain't gonna even lie. But yeah, well, I'm gonna get away from over here. But nah, man. So you know, out there in East Warren, dog. Like, you know, you say it was smooth growing up, like regular household type vibe.
Yeah, most definitely. Yeah.
Yeah, for shit so. So, the day-to-day program in East Warren, man, if I come through there, what I'ma see, what I'ma do, what?
Man, when I be in the hood, it be all love, for real. Like, everywhere I go, you feel me? People come out, you feel me? It be love everywhere, like, you feel me? That shit be cool, for real, because there don't really be too many outsiders over there, motherfucker. So, if you over there, then you over there with somebody that's from over there. You know what I'm saying? So, right. You don't really be too many outsiders. So, like, if I bring somebody over there, and they know you came with me, so you good, obviously, if I bring you over there with them.
For shit. So, you know, what made you jump into this rap shit, man? How long you been doing the rap thing?
Shit, I ain't gonna lie. I've been rapping all my life, for real. Since I was little, for real. I beat on the table. I just always rap, for real. Yeah. Like, since I was probably, like, as far back as I can remember, probably since I was like 6-7 years old.
Yeah.
Rapping, for sure.
That's what's up. Nah, you know, Detroit got a very sound that's distinctive. You know, it don't sound like nobody else, kind of similar to the Bay. A lot of people would compare it to the Bay. But me, I listen to a lot of Bay Area music, so I don't even say it's the same. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. To be honest, it's similar. With the slap sometime, but I'm like, nah, them niggas really something completely different. But the artists out here, you know, y'all got a similar sound, and, you know, it seems like y'all don't try to jump on nobody else's wave, man. It's like Detroit gonna come out as Detroit.
Yeah, most definitely. See, that's because in Detroit, it's so much with, like, when you hear niggas rap for real, it's so much that go on in Detroit for real. Like, nigga, you got a lot to rap about, for real.
Yeah.
You feel me? Especially if you really rapping about shit that you doing and you seeing, because, like, being in Detroit, you going to go through something. You going to see something. It's going to be something to talk about, you feel me, on a day-to-day basis. You feel what I'm saying?
Yeah.
You can walk outside and see a shootout. You can walk outside, get into a shootout, anything. You know what I'm saying? All that shit, you see that shit every day. So, it's like I say, it's so much going on in Detroit on a day-to-day basis. Like, that's where the music really be coming from, for real. You listen to it, for real. That's why they be like, Detroit really got their own sound and their culture, because what goes on in Detroit, that's what everybody be on. You know what I'm saying? Niggas just turn that shit into music, for real, and rap about it.
Yeah. Nah, because, like, one thing for sure, I know, like, a lot of artists in a lot of different cities, man, you know, they'll have their sound, but niggas will start sounding like the hottest artists that's in the game, like the hottest city that's popping, or, like, you know, some people, it's not like they just, oh, I'm gonna jump on Atlanta dick, but it's like, this would get the money, so I'm gonna use an Atlanta sounding song or a certain city that's popping. But Detroit is the city where I'm like, every nigga flow, I might see these niggas listening to Gunna or Lil Baby on their story or Gucci on their story, but nobody out here never made a song that sound like a Gucci Mane song that I hear, you know what I'm saying?
I mean, yeah, for the most part, a lot of people, like for the most part, a lot of people be still in Detroit sound and shit we be talking about for real. You feel me?
Cause, yeah.
Cause that shit so unicorn. You feel what I'm saying? Like it ain't nothing you see everywhere for real. When they do get a hold to Detroit or hear our sound, the motherfuckers from out of town be trying to sound like us for real.
Yeah.
But don't get me wrong, you do got some niggas from the city that be trying to sound like other niggas too. But for the most part, like you say, you ain't really gonna catch niggas doing that, cause shit, we on our own wave for real, and our wave hot, and what we sound like, we sound different. So the niggas that be really sticking to it and run with it, gonna be the niggas that motherfuckers rock with for the long term for real. You feel me?
Yeah, for shit show. Nah, man. So you know, a lot of people gonna ask the question, man. You know, with the name Wheelchair Goat, you know what I'm saying? So what's the situation with that?
Really, I ended up getting the name Wheelchair Goat. I originally was going under Marty D for real for a long time and shit.
Okay.
And then, but me being in a wheelchair, my Instagram was called Wheelchair Goat. You feel me? So when I was getting booked and shit like that, motherfuckers, you know, like when they put motherfuckers up on flyers and shit like that, they put them up on as their Instagram name.
Yeah.
So when I was going out and shit like that, motherfuckers just start calling me from what they were seeing on social media. So motherfuckers be like, Wheelchair Goat, or you Wheelchair Goat, you feel me? So shit, the Wheelchair Goat, my social media, you know, social media like one of the quickest ways to blow up for real, especially now in this day and age, you feel me? So motherfuckers be more in tune with the internet for real. So more people was knowing me for being Wheelchair Goat than who I was and shit. So I had just, you feel me, switch that shit over, switch my name to Wheelchair Goat, and just ran with that shit for real.
Okay, that's what's up, man. That's what's up. Nah, cause a lot of people who like in a wheelchair, man, you don't see artists this good, man. I'm pretty sure niggas got it. You feel me? I know niggas got it, but it's like, shit, you a nigga that's coming out like, hey, nigga, ain't nothing different. Ain't nothing sweet. Like, yeah, it's still the same.
Shit, I ain't gonna lie. Being in a wheelchair for me, it ain't really stopped nothing for real. Like the same shit that niggas, the regular average nigga going around doing and dealing with, I be in them same places dealing with that same shit for real. You feel me? I just take that shit and put it to my music. Like that shit be real for real. You feel me? That shit be shit that really be going on for real.
Yeah, nah, there's some of the bars, you know what I'm saying? Like, you know, you play off the bars of your situation, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, cause I try and make it entertaining too.
Yeah, no, that's what I say. It's like you make it real entertaining.
I try and make it entertaining too. So you feel me?
I think what the fuck you said on that track, man? I stood taller than these niggas.
Put in more leg work than niggas and I'm paralyzed.
Yeah, put in more leg work than niggas and I'm paralyzed, man.
That shit was real though.
Nah, that shit hard. I ain't gonna lie, that shit was hard. But nah, man. So you been paralyzed your whole life or?
Nope, I end up when I was. I was nine years old, going on 10, I had ended up getting shot and shit.
Yeah.
On a little neighborhood I was living in, a little bad neighborhood I was living in, like on 6 Mile and shit, I had ended up getting shot.
Yeah.
When I was 9 years old and shit, that's how I got in the wheelchair.
Okay, damn. Yeah. But nah, man, you a soldier for real, dog. Like, man, you, like I say, I'm looking at you like, yeah. I can't look at you no different.
Because
hey, the confidence, the energy, I hit you right up.
That's because my people ain't having that shit. Like my team, like they ain't having that old sympathy, you handicapped, like type shit. They ain't going for that shit for real. That shit came from having a strong team of people around me for real. You feel me? Them motherfuckers, they treat me normal. You feel what I'm saying? So, shit. Like, them niggas weren't having all that sitting around sad and like, nigga, shit, nigga, what's up? You wanna go outside and race, nigga? Go play football, basketball? I was still doing that shit as a kid for real, you feel me? Like, I was never left out for real. That's where the confidence in, you feel me? Just knowing and just seeing that shit. Like, motherfuckers that was around me let me know, like, nigga, you still, shit, nigga, we don't look at you no different for real. Like, nigga, you still normal to us, nigga, for real. Yeah. A lot of motherfuckers be thinking I be playing in this motherfucker, though. I done had people ask me like, cause I look so normal. They be like, "Why you playing in a wheelchair?" Like, bitch, I ain't playing in no fucking wheelchair.
For sure. So. Nah, you just rapping. It's like we don't never see niggas that rapping and that cold with it for real like that. So it's like that. See this nigga go hard with it and be good at it. It's a big difference in the shit.
Yeah.
But that's what's up, man. That's what's up.